السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وكنتين إن شاء الله تعالى with سورة ياسين. And we'll go through إن شاء الله verses 51 to 54. 51 to 54. And I would like to remind myself and everyone, there's a disadvantage to the distant learning when it comes to matters of deen, and that is the non-physical presence, like in the masjid, which has a great effect in how the hearts are affected with ilm. There's nothing like of it, of course, whatsoever. But we have to put effort to benefit from this distant learning and listening to recordings and things like this. By putting the effort and acting upon what we learn, and which is an advantage, right? So we have to look at the bright side of things, because if you are in a masjid and you listen to tafsir or so, your heart is more affected, hopefully, and makes it easier to act upon what we hear, and that's what the fruits of it. But sometimes people, they are only satisfied with attending lectures. And they feel good, then that's their only share of what they hear. No, it has to be translated into actions. So as long as we act upon what we hear and we put the effort, inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would bless our gatherings and to make it benefiting for all of us, inshallah. So I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that, and that's a reminder for myself and everyone, is to put the effort in learning and acting as the sahaba radiallahu anhu. Okay, start with the recitation of the ayat, inshallah. Repeat after me, inshallah. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. ونفخ في الصور فإذا هم من الأجداث إلى ربهم ينسلون. قالوا يا ويلنا من بعثنا من مرقدنا هذا ما وعد الرحمن وصدق المرسلون إن كانت إلا صيحة واحدة فإذا هم جميع لدينا محضرون فاليوم لا تظلم نفس شيئا ولا تجزون إلا ما كنتم تعملون So here, the ayat. ونفخ في الصور فإذا هم two counts فإذا هم من الأج the جيم with سكون قلقلة من الأجداث إلى ربهم ينسلون إخفاء ينسلون قالوا يا ويلنا من بعثنا the ميم sound ميم ميم The noon does not exist. It's idgham with ghunna. مِمْ مَرْقَدِنَا هَذَا مَا وَعَدَ الرَّحْمَانُ وَصَدَقَ الْمُرْسَلُونَ As we know that you might have a sect here after مَرْقَدِنَا, whether to stop without taking a breath if you continue, or you can stop as we did in the recitation and you continue afterwards, full stop. So you can do it in both ways. You can say it like this. قَالُوا يَا وَيْلَنَا مَنْ بَعَثَنَا مِنْ مَرْقَدِنَا هَذَا مَا وَعَدَ الرَّحْمَنُ وَصَدَقَ الْمُرْسَلُونَ. Like I stopped without taking a breath after the word مَرْقَدِنَا. Or you say it like that. قَالُوا يَا وَيْلَنَا مَنْ بَعَثَنَا مِنْ مَرْقَدِنَا هَذَا مَا وَعَدَ الرَّحْمَنُ وَصَدَقَ الْمُرْسَلُونَ. I stopped, complete stop, and I took breath and everything. فَالْيَوْمَ لَا تُظْلَمُ, I'm sorry, إِنْ كَانَتْ إِخْفَاء, إِنْ كَانَتْ إِلَّا صَيْحَةً إِضْغَامُ الْغُنَّةِ واحدة إخفاء فإذا هم جميع لدينا, جميع لدينا وذود غنة, جميع لدينا محضرون. فاليوم لا تظلم نفس إخفاء, نفس شيئا إدغام, ولا تجزون قلقلة إلا ما كنتم إخفاء تعملون. ونفخ في الصور, the translation is, and the trumpet will be blown, and behold, from the graves they will come out quickly to their Lord. So this is the second blow of the trumpet, or the third, according to some, which is basically the last one. The blow on the trumpet for everyone to be resurrected. So this is the first one, because there's a trumpet and there's an angel there is required to, and this is his job, and he's waiting to be commanded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The first one is for everyone to die. And then the second one, which is to blow in the trumpet for people to be resurrected. For people to be resurrected. And this is basically refers to the resurrection one. وَنُفِخَ فِي الصُّورِ. And as-sur is the trumpet again, as we said, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best how big and how it is. It is sufficient by the will of Allah for everyone to die. And the same sur, if it's blown in it, by the will of Allah, by the power of Allah, everyone will be resurrected. And life or death to all of the human beings is like one soul. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned then in the Quran, that مَا بَعْثُكُمْ إِلَّا كَنَفْسٍ وَاحِدَةٍ. Which is يعني ما خلقكم ولا بعثكم, ما خلقكم ولا بعثكم إلا كنفس واحدة إن الله سميع بصير. That your creation nor your resurrection except like one soul by the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imam al-Sa'di رحمه الله, he says this is the you know the, as is this is refers to the nafkha or the blow that with the resurrection. So if that is done, خرجوا من الأجداث والقبور. They come out of the ajdath and their graves. يَنْسِلُونَ إِلَى رَبِّهِمْ. يَنْسِلُونَ, that means they go in haste. They have no choice whatsoever. Everyone is resurrected and they're going to the direction to be present and for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to judge between them. No one can be delayed. No one can stop. No one can escape. And in that state, the مُكَذِّبُونَ, the deniers, will be in such a misery and regret. And the hasra and the regret that is over them is something that can never be explained. No matter what you think of hasra and regret in this life is only temporary and it's, you know, it's not going to be forever. But when the hasra and the regret is for an everlasting state that a person is going to be in, there's no way to fix it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from the hellfire. So, وَنُفِخَ فِي الصُّورِ. ونفخ في الصور فإذا هم, فإذا هم, like all of a sudden, that's what we'll talk about inshallah ta'ala also. And this إذا, like that is like a surprise thing. فإذا هم من الأجداث. And الأجداث is the grave. فإذا هم من الأجداث إلى ربهم, to their Lord. ينسلون, ينسلون is when you walk fast. And we'll talk about that word, النسلان. And the Prophet ﷺ, when he advised the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, when they asked of the Prophet, complained to the Prophet ﷺ that they feel lazy, sometimes he said, عليكم بالنسلان, walk fast. When you walk fast, it takes away the laziness. So So this is describing the state of resurrection. وَنُفِخَ فِي الصُّورِ فَإِذَا هُمْ مِنَ الْأَدِدَاثِ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَنْسِلُونَ قَالُوا يَا وَيْلَنَا مَنْ بَعَثَنَا مِنْ مَرْقَدِنَا. They would say, woe to us, who has raised us up from our place of sleep? Then it will be said to them, this is what the most beneficent Allah had promised, and the messengers spoke truth. قَالُوا يَا وَيْلَنَا مَنْ بَعَثَنَا مِنْ مَرْقَدِنَا. So who are the ones that said that? You know, this is refers to the disbelievers. The disbelievers, those who would say that. And it can be valid for others. That means this is, you know, people are surprised of the resurrection itself. And يَا وَيْلَنَا is usually a word that it refers to musiba or a calamity or a regret. And الويل, whether it's a valley in Jahannam or refers to a bad state that a person is in. And that's, of course, refers to the disbelievers because of what they're coming ahead of them, which they are resurrected to be thrown into the hellfire forever. So قالوا يا ويلنا من بعثنا من مرقدنا. Who is the one that resurrected us from مرقدنا? From المرقد is the place of sleep. Because they disbelieved in the hereafter. من بعثنا من مرقدنا. Who answered them? Some said it's the believers. Some said it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the angels. So هذا ما وعد الرحمن. This is what الرحمن, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most beneficent, promised. وصدق المرسلون. The مرسلون, the messengers of Allah, they were truthful. And Imam Sa'di رحمه الله, he said, do not think that the mention of الرحمن in this context is just to inform about the promise of Allah, but also it to inform us that in that great day, people will see from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala where people cannot even think or comprehend. And nobody would ever imagine that how vast is the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's the like of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Al-mulku yawma'idhin al-haqqu lil-rahman. In the day of judgment, the real sovereignty and kingdom on that day, al-haqq, the truth, is to ar-Rahman, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most beneficent, the most merciful. وَخَشَعَتِ الْأَصْوَاتُ لِلْرَّحْمَنِ. The voices will be humbled down to ar-Rahman, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most merciful. So all of that, it shows the significance of the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ar-Rahman, in this context. And with the disbelievers saying that. And that's where the believers will rejoice because of that vast mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إن كانت إلا صيحة واحدة فإذا هم جميع لدينا محضرون. It will be but a single صيحة, shout. So behold, they will all be brought up before us. إن كانت إلا صيحة واحدة. This is like what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Nazi'at. فإنما هي زجرة واحدة. It's only one زجرة. فإذا هم بالساهرة. وما أمر الساعة إلا كلمح البصر أو هو أقرب. The matter of the hour is like a blink of an eye. Or even closer, right? And the many verses in the Quran that talks about how close the matter is. So it's one command, in kanat, and that's referring to the resurrection from the graves, illa, except sayhatan wahida, one shout. Israfil, the angel would blow in the trumpet, and everyone would be given life. Fa'idahum jami'un ladayna muhbarun, also fa'idahum, all of a sudden. No transition, doesn't take thousands of years of or millions of years or any time, just immediately. فَإِذَا هُمْ جَمِيعٌ, all of them, لَدَيْنَا, to us, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, مُحْضَرُونَ, مُحْضَرُونَ, present, the first and the last and the human beings and the jinn, everyone, to be held accountable for their actions. And the last ayah for today, فَالْيَوْمَ لَا تُظْلَمُ نَفْسٌ شَيْئًا وَلَا تُجِزَوْنَ إِلَّا مَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. This day, none will be wronged in anything, nor will you be requited anything except that which you used to do. فَالْيَوْمَ, on that day, the day of judgment, لَا تُظْلَمُ نَفْسٌ شَيْئًا, no nafs, no soul, will be treated with any injustice whatsoever. No one will be given less in the rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one will have more of sins that they didn't earn. وَلَا تُجِزَوْنَ, and you would not be recompensed except إِلَّا مَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ, except what you used to do, whether it's good or evil. So فَمَنْ وَجَدَ خَيْرًا, whoever finds good, فَلْيَحْمَدِ اللَّهِ, he should be grateful to Allah and praise Allah. ومن وجد غير ذلك, and whoever finds other than that فلا يلومن إلا نفسه. He should not blame anyone except his own self, and that's what the disbelievers and the sinners will be upon. So, and you can see clearly what's the benefit of that mentioned now here in our life, to make and to take actions and to regret now. The regret now is a beautiful thing before the regret in the day of judgment, and to fill our book of deeds with khayr, with goodness and repentance and seeking forgiveness from Allah, and to change the evil actions with good actions. When we look at the words of the ayat, وَنُفِخَ and نُفِخَ, that's referring to those who denied the day of judgment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is informing us of what's going to happen in details. And نُفِخَ, نُفِخَ from نَفَخَ, which is something blown, right? And anything that is blown, when you blow on something, نَفَخْتُ فِي النَّارِ, like you blow into a fire. So this is what النَّفْخ, breathing into something. وَنُفِخَ فِي الصُّور, فِي in الصُّور. الصُّور is again the trumpet from صَاد وَاو رَاء. And a sur is again, you know that image of a trumpet. This is what is it called? This is what something that has a originally comes from even the word surah, right? An image. So it's something that has a shape, which is here again refers to the trumpet. It's a specific word for the trumpet. ونفخ في الصور فإذاهم فإذا, as they translate, is behold. All of a sudden, فجائية, they call it إذا الفجائية, فجائية, all of a sudden one, surprise one. فإذا هم, all of a sudden they, فإذا هم من الأجداث, from جيم دال ثاء, which is the graves. And this is one of the words of the graves. الأجداث is القبور. فإذا هم من الأجداث إلى ربهم, to their Lord, إلى ربهم, ينسلون from نسلة. And as we said, نسلة is to walk in haste, to walk fast, while the footsteps or the steps are close to one another. And then النسل is the offsprings. And that comes from when someone is comes from another, like the baby when it's detached from its mother. So that's النسل and progeny. Basically, it refers to the word progeny. النسلان is to walk fast. قالوا, they said, قالوا يا ويلنا, woe to us. Ya is nida, is calling. ويل is, this is the word of regret or wailing or saying woe to us. And that's us is the noon alif. It's basically al-wail is destruction, is when someone is destroyed, and it also refers to a valley in Jahannam that is destructive one. قالوا يا ويلنا من بعثنا, who بعثنا from بعث, raised us, and the بعث is something when something is excited or moves from its place. من بعثنا من مرقدنا, from مرقدنا, our sleeping place, and the noon alif, our marqad, and comes from ra qaf dal, and the ruqad or raqada, raqada with a dal is the when someone it sleep, right? It refers to a sleeping place. Al marqad is the sleeping place, raqada is to sleep, and the people would say harqud, sa'arqud, not with a dal. Dad is that you're gonna run, al raqd with a dad is running. But with a dal, with a raqada, it means that you would sleep. But it's to be more even precise, it's what is pleasant of a short amount of sleep. That's what basically a ruqud. And it's mentioned in Surah Al-Kahf, وَهُمْ ruqud, وَكَلْبُهُمْ بَسْطَةٌ رَعِيهِ بِالْوَصِيدِ. وَهُمْ ruqud, the people of the cave, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that they ruqud as if they're, even though they slept for a long period of time, but it's it was something that is small compared to the real death. So قالوا يا ويلنا من بعثنا من مرقدنا. هذا, this is, or هذا ما, this is what wa'ada promised, what wa'ada ar-Rahman, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most beneficent, the most merciful, wa sadaqa truthful al-mursalun from ra sin lam. In kanat, it will be nothing but illa sayhatan. Sayha, we talked about that, for sadia ha, shout, wahida, one. Fa'idha, all of a sudden, again, behold, fa'idha hum jami'un ladayna, all of them. Ladayna before us, muhdarun from hadara, will be brought, will be present, all of them. Falyawma, therefore, this day, al-yawm, falyawma la tuzlamu, no tuzlam. Tuzlam wronged from vod, lam, mim. None would be wronged. Nafs, a soul would never be wronged. Shay'an, anything, whether it's small or major. Wala tujizawna, and you would not be recompensed. Jim zaya, tujizawna, recompensed. Illa ma kuntum, except what you used to ta'malun. And as we see here with these verses again, it's such an important reminder for all of us with regards to the Day of Judgment, and it's responding to the disbelievers, those who disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who they always make mockery of the Day of Judgment, and when is it, and when is that, and it's when it's there. And it's again, the message of the Quran always shows that this is very near, and what comes, anything that is coming is very near. And that's the belief in the last day. The hour comes all of a sudden, as the verse says, and all by the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it shows the justice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then the verses afterwards will talk about the believers and versus the disbelievers. So all of that is by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us benefit from what we hear. And don't forget to try to memorize, inshallah. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa barakatuh Muhammad wa sallam wa sallam wa rahmatullah.